Hi, my name is Elke from Belgium, and I would like to know if a writer nowadays still can tell the truth in a myth without it being a pure formula. I'm thinking of Pan's Labyrinth, which is a very good story. I mean, very it tells the truth, but I think there's a bit of a problem with the pure telling of the myth. So that's what I would like to know. Thank you.
Well, you're conflating truth and myth in the same sentence somehow, and as if they were counterparts to one another. Truth is a huge question, a huge thought. I mean, what, you know, writers are struggling to express the truth, and what is the truth? And the truth, as I've said in lecture, is not what happens outwardly in a story, but the writer's perception and ultimate dramatization of the deep hows and whys. What expresses the truth in any life is how and why human beings go about doing the things they do. And the whys, of course, can be subconscious, contradictory, very complex. But somehow, when a writer manages to express beautifully the deep hows and whys of human behavior, we as audience react to that thinking, ah, that's the truth. That's what really goes on inside of human beings. That's the real reasons why they do the things they do. And we have a sense of the truth. Myth is an encapsulation, a story that has captured some kind of truth. The myth of Narcissus, for example, telling the story of how this beautiful young man saw his reflection in the pond and fell in love with himself, hence leading us to the word narcissistic, someone in love with himself. And then he's so in love with his reflection is so beautiful that as he goes toward his reflection, of course, he drowns in his own reflection. That myth of Narcissus expresses a truth, that indeed, if people fall desperately in love with themselves, the results could be very self-destructive. And so myths then have captured these essential truths. And just because a writer takes a myth and creates a story around the myth doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to hang on to the essential truth that the myth contained. They can, in the telling of the story, somehow contradict that myth or destroy the essence of it. Because these myths are often very brief, and when you make a full-length work, it becomes far more complicated than the simple myth of Narcissus. And so the danger is that the truth of the myth may be lost in the telling. And I don't know in Pan's Labyrinth, if the essence of that myth was destroyed in making the film or tainted somehow. My impression was that I enjoyed the film a great deal. But I don't think there's any necessary contradiction between the truths that myths hold and your struggle as a writer to express the truth using this myth one way or the other. Ultimately, you may want to take the myth, turn it on its head, and say just the opposite. I mean, you could take a fairy tale like Hansel and Gretel and make it a story about two really mean-spirited kids who deliberately go out into the wood hunting witches and capture one of them and destroy her. And kids are mean like that. They could, you know, all witches could be in great danger in this world if little kids have their way. And so the truth, I think, is up to you when you choose a myth. The truth that ultimately you express as a writer has to be particular to your telling of that myth, and you're under no obligation to preserve the truth that was in the original myth.